Like to call upon the next speaker, Mr. Vikas Deshmukh, Vice President, Technology Center of Excellence, Reliance Industries Limited, Hydrocarbon Business. Mr. Vikas has more than 26 years of industry experience, covering the gamut from refinery, petrochemicals, IT, automation, and technology consulting. With his experience and expertise, he has held different portfolios, such as project manager, techno-functional consultant, technical advisor, delivery lead, automation engineer, and operations and technical services engineer. Vikas is a graduate in petrochemical engineering from Pune University and has a postgraduate diploma in supply chain management from IIT Delhi. He is currently doing his MBA. Mr. Vikas, please.
Good morning, all. Thank you, Mr. Raman. And Mr. Andy Chedda for setting up the stage from the perspective that he has given a good overview from the technology perspective. And I am going to talk more from the business perspective. So that from the audience perspective, I feel that is really set the context. And this is, in fact, almost after 5 years, 2012, I had given presentation here, maybe in Hyderabad ARC Forum on advanced analytics. And this is the second opportunity ARC has given to me. Thank you, Mr. Raman, Mr. Andy Chedda. So coming to the topic, it is a digital. Today everybody is talking about digital, and after great success of our day-to-day needs of our transport, our Uber and Ola business model, all the businesses are aspiring to be digital. On everything, right from the operation to the whole supply chain, every business aspire to be digital. So I will take you through first, give a brief introduction. Mr. Raman has already given. I am coming from manufacturing, refining and petrochemical. That's mainly, we call it as a petroleum downstream sector. And I'm industry, Reliance Industries Limited. So I would like to give some brief overview of Reliance Industries. Reliance Industries was founder Mr. Dhirubhai Ambani in 1966, that journey started, and where our, because Reliance motto that you all are aware that growth is life. So till 2000, from 1966 to 2017, if you could see this, today we are setting up world's largest petrochemical complex in Jamnagar. That project is J3. So J3 is that is the third major project in Jamnagar. So those projects are coming up in Jamnagar, and one of the projects like paraxylene, that as part of petrochemical, that the largest petrochemical plant has already started and is in operation. So this is what Reliance business at a glance. So the primarily Reliance last almost 20 years, it's refining and petrochemicals that has been the focus area and maybe the revenue generator for Reliance industry and till today as well. And on upstream side, oil and gas, then last 10 years, I think 2007, Reliance entered in retail market as well. And now subsequently digital services, and Reliance is also showing a lot of interest in media and entertainment. So this is the financial performance of Reliance for last 1 year. And this is the process flow, product flow diagram rather, for each sector, right, starting from upstream exploration, refining, petrochemical, what are the number of products produced by the different plants. So coming to the main topic, I think Mr. Andy has defined a digital enterprise in a very nice way. And to me, it is a digital enterprise is nothing but an organization that uses technology as a competitive advantage and integrate information, work processes, work and people to bring about organizational change and drive efficiency and productivity. So this is what the most of the industries are looking for. And if you look at a financial industry or maybe a media, entertainment, most of the industries as on today are almost turning out to be almost 100% digitalization. But if you come to manufacturing industries, and today even oil and gas refining or petroleum downstream sector, this I would say digitalization index is comparatively low. I would like to give a reference of it's only last year McKinsey has given a good report which I think which is of use to every industry, that is the digitalization index of all the industry. So looking at that with reference to that report, the petroleum downstream industry for which I am working, so that industry, the digitalization index is comparatively low. And I'm trying to give some business perspective here. So, and if you look at a digital journey, it started almost 40 years back, 1978 to 2016. So if you could look here, it's last 2-3 years, you can see the industry 4 came up with the motive of convergence of information technology and operating technology. And this IIC, that consortium was set up, and that was purely to promote the digital growth of the industry. So these, the way the things are moving, from that perspective, industries are also getting good guidelines to start their journey to achieve the destination of digitalization. So from the business point of view here, if you look yesterday, so majority of the industry, the business focus was on maintaining the business. But lot of technology which are giving speed to the business, so that is motivating the industry, and that they are setting their goal from maintaining the business to growing the business. Now secondly, business model is changing from consumption based model. Earlier the focus was more on globalization, digitalization, but if you look today, industry is not more focusing on digitalization or globalization or industrialization. They are focusing more on consumption based model, and where the digital is going to add a lot of value, because the way this consumption based model, digital is helping me to achieve this consumption based model. Then second thing is increased demand, number of technology like cloud, digital, that is going to help me to bring in agility and bringing the connected and future ready system to my industry. Secondly, if you look at the earlier days and today's, the technology delivery models, earlier most of the IT companies, they were sticking to waterfall or SDLC type of model, and with the agile and DevOps, you can implement your IT projects rapidly. So that is the key advantage of digital. And as I just mentioned, this digitalization index of petroleum industry, so that is the motivating thing or exciting thing for us, the companies like Reliance and these things, so going for digitalization. But in the path of digitalization, these are the current challenges which industry is facing. So from first is the organizational safety and operational risk visualization. For hydrocarbon industry like us, There are a lot of challenges involved. There could be spillage of hydrocarbon. Personal safety is also important. Hundreds of people, thousands of people engaged in different job, and they are exposed to the type of hydrocarbons they are handling. Their safety is of utmost importance. But the way employees are engaged into the operations, from the management perspective, the amount of risk that is not visible. What type of risk as on today? So the probably digital can provide a good platform wherein on not on real time basis but on day to day basis that organization can see the risk, what type of risk my employees are at. So that if they are able to see, that is going to give a big and even digital can, I am sure digital can help in that achieving that goal. Then second is the competency assurance of workforce without facing safety aspects of live operating plants. Today, a plant engineer coming to me and saying before going into implementation due to hazardous nature of the plant, can I simulate my operation before I implement so that I can see my results in advance? So those type of advanced computing. Secondly, the new generation, the field operators or maybe field engineers, the crew, they all are gadget savvy. If I tell them, you take this operating manual, read this in a week and get back to me, I will validate your performance. They are not ready to go through. So what they are excited about the 3D type of training system, wherein they can have a virtual tour. So there the opportunities like virtual reality, augmented reality that digital is creating. So those type of opportunity we are seeing that can cater to the requirement of competency assurance of the workforce. Then second is the rapid and concise information not available to management on critical data and information issues. So Andy has shown a good in tabular format from the reactive to perspective, prescriptive. So that is the predictive and prescriptive. And the next stage I would say from the perspective is the cognitive. And today management is the way the information is getting generated today, whether it's operating plants, whether the finance, whether it is a safety or the number of incidents which are happening, the lot of the way data is getting generated over the period, it is finding difficult for the industry to retrieve the right information. Because today my technical services engineer, if he has to work or produce some report, say if his manager asks him to produce a root cause analysis report for something which has went which has gone wrong yesterday, and it takes almost more than a week because he has to search information from 10 different systems and gather that information, compile that information and put it into a report format. So here the cognitive we feel that will be of great use, where the fast search he can that whatever information from 10 different system he can gather correctly, and he can produce the report which is required for his management, and that is where the importance of artificial intelligence platform is. So then next is supply chain uncertainties, volatility in both feed and supply and end products, and that is leading to missed opportunity. So the another major problem what industry that petroleum downstream what we are facing is from the supply chain perspective is the sensing the demand. So that because I just spoke about in the previous slide, that is the consumption based model. So if I can sense my demand effectively, then that will also help my production team
to generate the product. So that will give a add a lot of value to the entire supply chain. And from that perspective, whether it is a logistic, whether it is a import of raw material like crude oil, or whether it is a dispatch of products through road, rail, or marine facility. So that is the digital is going to give a big boost to the whole supply chain by providing the speedy information through digital technology. Then last is the lack of predictability and non-connected enterprises. Fortunately, petroleum, most of the plants are running and they have been already provided with a lot of sensors. But there are some areas in terms of monitoring the corrosion, and definitely there is a need for smart sensors, and which can over the period connected to a good data analytics platform and will provide advanced alerts to the end user that will improve the availability of the plants. So from looking at the after discussing the challenges, so these are the opportunity areas from a digital perspective. I just spoke about real-time operational risk visualization, then 3D plant modeling, then sensors and industrial IoT, then cognitive computing and integrated supply chain. So with this platform, it's really because everybody talks about operation excellence, but how to make that excellence operational? So it is the digital which can make this, which is going to set the goals for the organization and is going to help achieving that digitalization goal for the petroleum downstream industry. So coming to the benefits, what we see from the digitalization, one for sure is reduced cost and risk. And this is, I would like to say, from the report which Harvard had published long back. I don't remember this the exact date, but the digitalization almost helps in reducing almost cost by 40%. So that is the one of the biggest benefit of digitalization. Then second is improved competency of operating personnel. I just mentioned about the new generation which is now getting into the manufacturing, operating the plants. So their demands are also of the new technology. They would like to undergo training in a 3D type of environment, virtual reality environment, rather than simply going through the operating manuals. So that is creating the new demand for the and from the organization management perspective, competency assurance of the people for safe operation of the plant is very, very important. Then higher productivity by doing more with less. So with this consumption based model, what I just mentioned, with the focus on that, this the one of the major benefit. Then predictability in decision making, then speed to the market, and scalable and agile. So coming to technology, in order to meet the business requirements and coming to the technology components, which probably I need to have in my overall application portfolio. So these are the platform which I would see that one and foremost is the simulation platform, wherein my technical services engineer or operation engineer, they can easily simulate and see the performance or outcome of the result before implementing into the system. Then data analytics and cloud. I just spoke about IoT and these smart sensor. So those are going to create data analytics and opportunity in cloud services area. Then next is artificial intelligence platform. Artificial intelligence platform is going to be of great help even in the area of manufacturing as well, because the information, the speed at which the information is going to be available to the frontline operator, that is really going to change his day-to-day life. Then next is integrated operational and risk visualization platform. Here I would like to talk a little bit on this thing, because currently most of the operations, the way things are happened, those are happening in a very scattered manner. So the integrated thing is very important. This is purely from the maintenance perspective and the operation perspective. So when I operation and maintenance team, they sit together, they make a plan for maintenance. From the maintenance plan itself, if they get a good platform to define the risk, what type of risk my people are going to get engaged when they are going to execute this job. So, and to the next level, when the job is going to be executed, who is going to execute that job, what is the type of job safety analysis is required to be done, what is the type of control of work which needs to be executed during execution of this job. So if they, and another thing is nowadays there are many video surveillance and video analytics systems that is also as a part of digital, those are coming up. So even the top management, some supercritical activities going inside their manufacturing plants with the help of video surveillance or maybe video analytics system, they can have a quick look at the what is really happening, whether the operations are happening in the safe manner or not. They can have a quick view of this. So that is what the management is looking at, and that is going to give the assurance to the management that yes, today looking at the risk, this is the amount of risk with, and if there is a high risk involved, but today whether it is a high risk or low risk or medium risk, there is no visibility available due to lack of operation risk visualization platform. So there are some technologies which are coming up in the market, and surely they will meet this requirement. Then smart sensors, again I mentioned this petroleum industry, almost most of the sensors, 80-90% of sensors are available, but definitely from improving the reliability of the plants, improving the availability of the plants and assets, these smart sensors are definitely useful, and connected to data analytics platform, that they are going to generate lot of wisdom for the maintenance and operating staff, which is required to ensure the high availability of their plants. So many times when we think about digital, so finally how does this digital model looks like? So I try to put it into a picture. So this is based on the digital platform. The way I look at that, I should be, from the industry perspective, I should be in a position to plan effectively, operate my plant safely. Then technical engineer, services engineer, or plant operations engineer, they should be able to monitor plant with lot of value addition. And secondly, I should be able to continuously improve in order to achieve the operational excellence. So that is very, very important. Can I have a glass of water? So the point I want to make here is that digital is really going to enhance continuous innovation, because the platform, when I talk to the client from the shop floor level and even to the managerial level, thank you, people are coming up with a lot of ideas, but when those ideas need to be implemented, we see that yes, what is lacking is the platform. So in order to start this digital journey, from the way I look at the industry problem, my industry problem or other industry problems, I feel that the architecture is very important. And it's incidentally, Mr. Andy has mentioned about the open process automation initiative. It's only last month I underwent this open automation presentation by ExxonMobil by Mr. Donald while at Birmingham. And that was gave a good insight into the open process automation. And the first thing I would say, in order to become a digital, or before setting a goal of becoming digital, what is most important is setting your architecture right. So once you set your architecture, so that's why this open process automation architecture is really going to help. Even we are also from petroleum downstream industry perspective also, we have also planned to move in that direction, because until and unless you solve your architecture related issue and make your platform strong, there is no point in talking about digital. So finally, looking at vision. People come to me and ask me, what is your digital vision? So looking at the digital vision, I always give the example of Ola and Uber, because I remember the days, it is not far, 2 years back, 4 years back, when I land to the airport, go outside and keep on searching the vehicles. And today when I land and before I reach the exit, the vehicle is available for me. This is really the hassle-free operation. The people are looking for the hassle-free services, which people are looking for, and every businesses. So from my industry perspective today, my assets, plants are slowly becoming self-aware. They are moving into self-predict mode. And the final goal, what is that we intend to keep, is that they should become a self-organized, all the asset, so that they know that what the problem, they should be able to predict their problems, they should be able to know what is the remaining life of the assets, and finally it should lead to a worry-free productivity. So from Reliance perspective, how Reliance is going to support digital, because it's almost more than 1 year Reliance got into 4G and coming up with a lot of data services for the individuals as well as for the different industries in the coming days, lot of offerings. And that is what, and I would like to mention here that after Industry 4 and Reliance started its subsequent to Industry 4, Reliance set up their vision of digitalization and IT-OT convergence. This is the statement Mr. Mukesh Ambani had made during NASSCOM. Data is a new oil for fourth industrial revolution. The foundation of the fourth industrial revolution is connectivity and data. Data is the new natural resource. We are at the beginning of an era where data is the new oil. So data is going to create a revolution that is for true, and this digital is really going to help in achieving that goal, and it is sure that digitalization is going to change everybody's life the way this Ola and Uber, they have changed the business model and they have made our life hassle-free and trouble-free. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much.